Previously on Transformers Prime.
Shockwave! I thought you'd perished on Cybertron.
The patch failed to yield any new information on the whereabouts of the Autobots.
I'd know the hum of that engine anywhere. Jackie!
We can't just give up.
Then tell me what we can do.
We know Starscream had access to a ground bridge.
He's clearly been using the Harbinger.
It could be full of Cybertronian tech.
Resources won't be of much use. Not without someone to lead us.
The Forge.
If you had the Forge, you could fix yourself up.
Meet Ultra Magnus.
I present to you, my liege, the ultimate Autobot Hunter.
Cybertronian history.
Indeed. But the specimen you see before you was bred in the laboratory. Cloned from fossilized remains, which I discovered on Cybertron.
Shockwave. It does my spark good to see you once again, tampering with creation.
Master, please, keep your distance.
No need for alarm. The beast is completely under my control.
Such primal magnificence.
A sample of Energon from Wheeljack. Spilled during the Autobots' failed interrogation.
Or blowing the scrap out of stuff. But what does flattening a Decepticon mine have to do with getting the band back together and taking down Megatron?
Simple. When we light up this place, the blast will be big and unmistakable.
Any Autobot within 500 clicks will see the sky glowing with Energon and come running.
Then bring the rain.
Mainframe's up and running. But I'll need help hacking the operating codes.
Even if the ground bridge proves functional, it will be next to worthless without a means of pinpointing the current locations of our compatriots. Use your head, Bumblebee. If the Decepticons had the ability to track Autobot signals, we'd have all been at Megatron's mercy here on Earth a long time ago.
Back where we started.
But not if I can reconfigure these Decepticon frequencies. At the very least, we may be able to access their comm link.
No one's seen or heard from you since Cybertron went dark. How did you find your way to Earth?
Soldier, we may not be on Cybertron, but military protocol remains.
My apologies, sir.
Sir?
Advise the native life form to watch its tone as well.
What? Who is this guy?
Ultra Magnus was Optimus's key lieutenant during the war back on Cybertron. Very by the book. Just go with it.
As for your broader question, my story is that of all Autobots since the Exodus. I wandered the spaceways in search of others, reuniting with some, often only to see them fall at the hands of the Decepticons.
until you detected the Omega Beam and followed it here.
If you're referring to the massive energy burst originating from Cybertron, that would be affirmative. Upon my arrival, it became evident that this planet had been invaded. My scanners also detected Autobot life signals, yours being in closest proximity to my position.
Signals, as in plural? Sir.
5 total.
Out of 7.
Jack, that doesn't necessarily mean what you're thinking. Autobot signals can't be detected when they're shielded.
Cozy little place you built for yourself, Megatron. Finding the Forge in there may take a while. Then again, maybe you still keep your valuables in the usual place.
I won't let you down, Optimus.
I'm sorry. Overreacting? Easy for you to say, knockout. Nobody here wants your post. I, on the other hand, hold the most coveted position within the Decepticon ranks. And no matter what he may claim, I know that Shockwave is plotting to usurp me. Did you see the smug look in his eye when he unveiled that vile beast to Lord Megatron?
You don't scare me, ugly. Hello, beautiful.
Munitions planted.
Let's get this party started.
Company.
Megatron?
Nah. Bigger. I don't remember seeing that move in Buckethead's repertoire.
Dragon. Giant flying fire breathing lizard.
Be hot to the touch.
Why isn't it coming after us?
You looking for me, beast? I'm right here.
We're gonna need more firepower.
Good thing I know just where to find some. And the walls came tumbling down.
Yes! Snuff the tragic dragon.
Does it matter?
For the save.
Thank the commander.
Soldiers? You?
Ultra Magnus? It's an honor.
It's an honor, sir.
Guess blowing that mine made us pretty easy to spot.
Ultra Magnus already had a bead on your signals, and ours. Care to tell us what exactly is nipping at our tailpipes?
We think it's a robot dragon.
Or a Cybertronian reptile.
Brace yourselves!
On top of us.
What is it now, Lord Megatron?
Agent Fowler, it's Ratchet.
Ratchet? Where's Jack? Is he with you?
No, he is not. Listen, we don't have much time. I have taken a tremendous yet calculated risk in contacting you. Hopefully, the Decepticons are not monitoring their own frequencies as closely as they no doubt are those of the humans. I am transmitting our current coordinates.
What? Ratchet, have you heard from anyone else? What about Prime? It's one of ours.
Girl's got a grip, doesn't she?
Disappointment this must be for you, Master. And to make matters worse, because it cannot speak, we have no way of knowing why the Predacon failed so miserably. Poor, mute, mindless creature.
New paid job looks good, B.
At least you had something to work with. If I reversed my colors, I'd be pink.
The communications link needs further calibration to be compatible with Autobot frequencies. The ground bridge, however, is fully operational.
That would have come in handy when Robo-Dragon was trying to eat us for breakfast.
The indigenous population of this planet, do they all display the same disregard for authority?
No. Mostly just Miko.
Don't shoot!
It's Fowler. He's with us.
It's okay, Mom. I'm fine.
Your families are safe. Agent Fowler saw to it that Jasper was evacuated in time.
The only signals Ultra Magnus was able to isolate are standing right here.
Maybe his scanner's faulty.
So the kid's unaccounted for.
Smokescreen bridged out unaccompanied. Only Optimus knows where. And Optimus remained behind. To destroy the ground bridge. To ensure that everyone else made it to safety.
I watched the base go down. No one or thing walked out of there.
Not that we could see.
Even if Prime survived, I'm not sure we can afford to wait for him to show up. Not with Megatron holding our planet hostage from his high and mighty perch at Darkmont.
I would be inclined to agree with the native life form. We must stop Megatron, with or without Optimus Prime.
Optimus! I have the forge. You can use it to repair yourself.
That is not the reason I had you retrieve the relic.
What? I don't understand.
The power of the forge is not unlimited. Its energy has already begun to ebb.
So it's running low. Who cares? All we need is enough juice to get you back into fighting shape.
Whatever power remains must be used to rebuild the Omega Lock, to restore Cybertron.
But that would mean...
the fate of all our kind is more vital than that of any one of us. Including me.
We must do everything in our power to ensure Megatron's downfall. But we will need to be smart about it.
Whoa, who put shoulder pads in command?
Temporary command.
Ultra Magnus is the only logical choice. He was trained by Optimus, and served as his commanding officer throughout the war for Cybertron.
Now, unless there is any further objection, soldier, please follow me.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Autobots! Take your pick.
Now you're speaking my language, sir.
Optimus, the Forge is a relic of the Primes. We can't use it to restore Cybertron. Not without a Prime. Not without you.
There will be a new Prime.
You can worry about that after we get you patched up and we take down Megatron.
The time for a new leader is upon us. In my spark, I believe that leader stands before me right now.